along the way, I've had incredible support, not only from the concentration, but also from my research advisors who have really helped to define my time at Harvard. The most rewarding moments, day in, day out, happened in my individual research experience in the lab that I eventually wrote a thesis in. And over the course of about 3.5 years, I was able to really develop a project that I was proud to call my own, and that each day I could think of new ways to advance and apply all of the concepts that I had learned in my fundamental courses to that research. And being able to take ownership over a project that to me was ultimately in a lot of ways very creative has been an incredible experience here at Harvard that has helped my intellectual development, not just in MCB, but also overall in terms of asking questions and being a problem solver.
Life sciences at Harvard for me means hands-on experience, not only being able to learn the techniques in class, but also apply them in a research setting. I work at the Broad Institute in a lab, and I can basically learn the techniques in class and literally half an hour later in lab apply them to dissect, you know, the cells and learn about how they express mRNA expression or gene expression.
The other exciting concept for me was in vitro evolution, or basically evolving nucleic acids in the lab and actually watching evolution happen before your eyes. And what was super awesome about Harvard is that after hearing about that in lecture, I was able to go and find the expert in that field. And I ended up working in Professor Jack Szostak's lab, working on the origin of life and evolution.
Meeting the different faculty, doing this groundbreaking research, it's radically changed the way I've thought about biology, how it's thought about science. I realized that through science and through research, I could actually one day be able to make the groundbreaking discoveries that perhaps could give a chance of life to a patient. I mean, there's over 11,000 faculty at Harvard that you can work with in a lab. I'm working in Richard Lee's lab, and I was starting my thesis, and our goal of the thesis is essentially to try to figure out whether we could find proteins within the pancreas that could help maintain these cells called beta cells outside the body. So it was this great endeavor to try to find this protein or these proteins within. So had no idea whether I would find anything beginning my thesis, and little did I know that a year and a half later, we actually would find a protein that worked. All this planification that I had a part in and that I really designed experiments for, I was able to find this thing that no one's found before. And I think that was probably one of the greatest moments I've ever had. I think Harvard's one of the few places in the world where you could go to your advisor or go to your PI or go to a scientist who's maybe doing something related work, propose this idea as an undergrad, and you can get the support for it. A lot of the time, especially freshmen and underclassmen, they feel a little bit scared about going and approaching advisors or professors to talk to them about the different like things going on in their lab or the things going on in the department. Professors are more than open and happy to allow a student, for example, to contact them and say, hey, I'm really interested in or curious about this work going in your lab. Could I go in and meet with you and talk to you? You should not be shy about doing that. Once you go through your first interview with a professor and then you get used to talking to them, I think it's pretty much easy going from there.
A lot of the professors doing research here are not expecting students to have any research experience. So if you haven't had any research experience, don't worry. You'll be able to gain that experience in no time when you start working in the lab. I would really advise students who are interested in doing research to put a lot of thought into what kind of questions really intrigue them, what kind of things that they are really interested in spending a lot of time figuring out, because that's what will eventually drive you to keep returning to the research that you're doing and keep working on it and spending time investigating those questions. I would also advise students to think about where they might find areas of their life intersecting. For example, I enjoy art, and I enjoy bringing that art into my research by looking at different pictures on the microscope with different colors and looking for patterns. I'm using my skills from art, and I'm bringing them into my interests in life sciences and neurobiology. So if you have different passions, find a way to combine them in your research that will make it even more enjoyable for you and even more natural.
The best thing about the life sciences is that it's very adaptable to your needs as an academic, but also the desires you have for future studies. Your chances to expand your mind and your focus happen throughout freshman and sophomore year. And then there's this lovely moment where you might find that you've discovered the thing that drives you or makes you very excited. And it doesn't have to be grand. It can be a very subtle, exciting, maybe model system or perhaps even theme within the greater scheme of biology, or you find a lab that you really enjoy, or you have a summer experience that blows your mind. I think that within the life sciences, there's this great ability to morph to what its students need. So always make sure that you're reaching out to your advisors and to professors, because if there's one thing about studies of biology, it's that adaptability is key. Know that you can always tailor the experience to what you want it to be.
Probably my biggest piece of advice is to just have the courage to follow the little intuitions that you have about what really will get you excited to explore and to take on.